Starting a conversation in Arabic. Actually, starting a conversation in Arabic or in any other language could be really difficult. And I know many people who get really intimidated and they don't get the actions that are needed in order to start a good conversation. In this video, I'll share with you some tips that you may need and find useful in order to start a conversation. In order to start a conversation, I have 6 tips for you. The first tip, do it. Just do it. Have the courage and have the guts to do it. So when you start a conversation, don't just wait until the perfect time. Just go in and start the conversation right away, because it could be a matter of seconds and the situation is changing and you don't have the chance to make this conversation after a few seconds. So just do it. This is the first step. The second tip, shake hands and say your name. This is very, very important because it happens a lot and happened to me that I shake hands and then I forget to say my name. And this is really not a good situation because sometimes you don't recap and you don't know the name of the other person, and the other person it usually doesn't say his name or her name at the same time as I respond to you, and this could end up being not able to know his name or her name, and the conversation is lacking a lot. So just say your name and concentrate well to hear and to listen to the person's name and try to retain it. This is very, very important and it will have a big effect later on. Be spontaneous. Spontaneous. This is very, very important. If you are making a conversation and you are approaching somebody, start a topic and talk casually, normally. Don't just pretend that you are searching for a topic and you are trying to come up with any form of blah 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 that doesn't stand for anything. Just be spontaneous. Ask about something that you really need to know. Ask about the weather. Discuss if there's a vacation coming soon. Discuss if the working conditions are difficult and you are complaining, or are good and you are feeling well. Also, you can discuss what you will do in the weekend, what you will do 1 hour later. A cup of coffee can be a good idea. There are many, many topics, and try to be as spontaneous and as casual as possible. There's nothing more difficult than pretending to make something, and it's really driving people mad. Be genuine. Be genuine or original. Don't try to imitate somebody else. Be your own style and stick to your own style. Don't try to change yourself. If you are a person who's joyful and who likes to cheer up and so on, this is your personality. If you are quite serious, it's okay as well. So be your personality. Don't try to change it for the sake of a conversation, because it turns really bad. So stick to your originality. Be genuine. Follow up, follow up, follow up, follow up. Very, very important. Don't start the conversation and cut it in the middle and that's all. Follow up. What do I mean by follow up? Follow up with the person. Try to make it like a ping pong. So try to make the conversation running. If he's run out of ideas, try to get ideas. If you run out, he will try as well to get ideas, so the conversation will keep working. Something also very, very important. If you end the conversation and there's a chance to follow up, don't lose this chance. Propose to make something to follow up this conversation. Propose to have a later phone call. propose, for example, to meet at a later date, or to give yourself a chance to know the person in any way, so that the conversation will continue even tomorrow, even next week. Try to continue and follow up. Don't just have the conversation and end it, and then nobody will see you again. Follow up. This is a key. Be appreciative. Be appreciative to others. In order, and also think of others. Be considerate. In order to have a successful conversation, it's something really, really bad and annoying to center all the conversation around yourself. So saying, I have done this, I am good at this, I want you to do this, and so on and so on, and speak about yourself. And don't give the other person any chance to speak about his feelings or to give information about himself. Make it reciprocal, make it mutual. So make the conversation two ways. Talk about yourself and listen to the other person. Listen to his ideas and be appreciative. If he is doing something good, tell him that this is good and you are appreciating it. It's really a positive energy going on between you two, and this will make the conversation more fun, and it will end up in different and many, many conversations to follow up afterwards. So these were some tips that are very, very important if you want to initiate a conversation, not just in Arabic, in any language with any human being. This is very, very important. Stick to these tips and try to make them real and try to apply them in real life. There are zillion of topics to talk about. Topics about yourself that you find really fun. Topics that are shared, that people find it really useful. Topics like traveling, like vacations, holidays, occasions. Topics like a cup of coffee, a morning, how you are dealing with morning and with the work and with the stress of work and with your daily activities. How do you get really a free time and get yourself some fun? How do you make a pause or a break from something? There are millions of topics, and there are a chance that you find the other person interested in these topics and he will give you the hook to make a topic. Maybe you talk about something and you find it really interesting and you can recap and talk about it, and therefore the conversation will be continuing between you two. So I hope that you liked this video and found it useful. Keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to comment if you have any information to share. If you have any question, I will be very, very happy to answer. Thanks a lot, and see you in future videos.